I want to give you guys a sneak peek of the podcast intro song. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. Okay, volume all the way up. Good morning, guys, and welcome back to the vlog. I just finished a workout and I look like ass. I probably should have just waited 30 minutes to shower and like get a little bit ready to start the vlog. Welcome to the vlog channel where we don't give a shit. Anyways, I have not been on my vlog game the last couple weeks, if I'm being honest. And we will get into that in a little bit today, but I am feeling motivated. I am ready to fill you guys in on the things that you have been missing, because honestly, your girl has just been going through it. But I haven't washed my hair in about 6 days, and it is time. It is time, y'all. Honestly, it looks pretty good. I swear I do those beach waves with that new waver tool I got, and my hair just like doesn't get greasy. It's honestly been 6 days and my roots feel pretty good. It just like kind of has an essence to it. Just gonna wash the hair, and then I think I might put some more waves in it, because like this hairstyle has been the move for me recently. Okay, hello. We are blow dried, washed, and makeup feeling fresh and clean, honestly. So decided not to wave my hair because I have a shoot tomorrow at the beach. So I'm not entirely sure if I want to actually make an effort with my hair. I have like that hair type that just like as soon as there's any moisture around just goes like. So I haven't decided what I feel like the move is gonna be for tomorrow's shoot. Anyways, I have been brainstorming like crazy different video ideas. And when I have a video idea, I just like immediately order supplies so that I can execute as soon as possible if I get like the rest of the inspiration to finish it. But I have to show you this fabric that I just got in the mail. I genuinely thought it wasn't gonna show up for like 2 more months, but like she cute. It is this bootleg Louis Vuitton spandex. Way stretchier than I thought it was gonna be, honestly, but oh my God, it is so cute. It's like rainbow sorbet, but like bootleg Louis Vuitton. I'm sure this is highly legal that people sell this, but I got so much of it. I think I ordered 2 yards, but I didn't realize what the width of it was gonna be. Oh, he bougie. He bougie, he a bougie mousse, he a bougie Louis Vuitton mousse. Wow, give us a strut, bubba. Give us a strut. Mousse, come here, come here. Yes, yes, work. Work, work, work. So anyways, I have a really fun idea for what I wanna do with this bootleg Louis Vuitton fabric. I'm excited and it's so, so cute. Oh my God, my hair is so clean. It feels so nice. It's been so dirty for so long. Basically, essentially, what's been happening is that I have been on the same anxiety medication for probably like 10 years now. It's been a super, super long time. So my prescription is called Celexa. That's like the brand name for it. And I started on 5 milligrams and eventually just worked my way up to a whopping 60 milligrams because I am an anxious bitch. What actually happens is that your body just learns to metabolize it. To get the same medicinal benefits, sometimes you just have to up your dosage, and that's the reality of it. It's been 10 years, like I get it. I understand that my body has just been processing the same medication for so long that I just feel like it isn't quite doing what it used to. So I've been just like having bouts of anxiety that are super irrational. I'm usually pretty good at kind of grounding myself and bringing myself back down and being very realistic and working through all my different techniques to manage my anxiety, but I feel like I've just been cloudy the last couple months. And so I worked with my doctor to kind of figure out a plan. So we gave it a little more time instead of just like going immediately over to switching to a new medication. But because I don't think I have any crazy side effects, which is pretty rare when you start a medication and stay on it for a long time, I was like, okay, well, like, what if I switch and I get some crazy side effect? Because like, this is exactly what I did to myself with birth control. I was on NuvaRing, everything was great, but I was like, do I just wanna change a pace? Obviously, there's like a whole other level to it because I feel like my anti-anxiety currently, anyways, it's not the exact same because obviously I feel like my medication is not working anymore, so there is a reason to switch. But when I was on NuvaRing, the birth control was totally fine for me. And then I got the Nexplanon stuffed in my arm and my life fell apart. So I'm a little nervous, obviously, about starting a new medication, but I've talked to my doctor and I am on a schedule to wean myself off the medication that I'm currently on. So I'm taking 1/3 of the dose that I've been taking for like the last 6 years. So I am just like a mess. mess of unbalanced brain chemicals currently. So I've just been feeling off and a little bit dizzy and just like cloudy. Next week I start a combination of a low dose of my old medication and a low dose of my new medication. So we'll see how it goes, but I just wanted to give you guys a heads up and also like a small explanation for why the vlogging has been a little bit, you should see Moose right now. He just stuffed his face. Moose, come here, Bubba, come here, big jumpies. Oh goodness, hello, that's just your butthole on screen, okay. Oh, that's very nice. So yeah, that is why the vlog game has not been great. I just haven't fully been feeling myself. And so hopefully things will start to get a little more clear for me. It's not like clear, I don't even know how to describe the cloudiness that I kind of feel when I feel like my medication's not working or I'm at a lower dose. It's just been, you know, an up and down of mental health as it always will be. When you're managing anxiety. So that's what's been going on. But on a happier, more fun note, I want to give you guys a sneak peek of the podcast intro song. So this is the version that doesn't have the vocals and the title in it, but this is like the actual track. Since it was made from scratch, I won't get copywritten, I don't think. Anyways, I'm gonna play it for you. It's a freaking bop and I'm so excited. So we finalized the podcast album artwork. We finalized our intro song. We finalized our trailer and description. So we actually had last night like our very first taste of actually doing a podcast and it was so much fun. Obviously our podcast network has to like go and sell our podcast around to like get ads placed onto it. So we don't have a launch date just yet, but I'm thinking August now. I don't see any reason why it wouldn't start in August because today is July 13th. What in the actual hell? July 13th? Oh my God, my birthday is in less than a month. I'm like old. Okay, anyways, let me play the song. It's a freaking bop and I'm so excited. Ow, Moose, ow. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. Okay, volume all the way up. So we had this made, we worked with a music producer to kind of like make something that we like super vibed with. And honestly, I was like, give me something Galantis-y because I love Galantis. Okay, so here it is. There's like a lyric at the end that goes like da, da, da on the end. Oh, I'm so excited. Oh my gosh, the version that has our voices on it and stuff with the title is so good. I literally am so addicted to just listening to it. Like it's an automatic bop in my brain. I'm not sick of it yet, which I think is a great sign. So that's where we are on the podcast front. And I'm so excited to get started. My hand is so dry. A bitch needs lotion immediately. Oh my God, hi. Okay, so I forgot my vlog camera, but I'm currently in the car. So this is a sentence I have truly never said, even off the vlog, I don't even think. And these are some fun topics that we will cover on the podcast, but I'm about to go into a weed store. So cannabis is legal in the state of California amongst many other states and Canada now. Honestly, I have witnessed so many medicinal uses, a big one of them being actually epilepsy with Baz. But anyways, I have been referred, recommended to so many different CBD-based products to help with my anxiety, especially in this transition period where I'm going between meds. You guys might remember that I have a medication that I can take when my anxiety is really bad, but it is something that's a little more intense that I don't really like to take that often. Like typically I would only take them on travel days. So I would love something that just like helps get me through days where I'm feeling 70% normal or something. So anyways, I'm literally about to go into this store with no knowledge, just that I want CBD and zero THC because I don't like the feeling of being high. Fun things that we'll discuss on the podcast. And just go in there and be like, hi, I'm an anxious bitch, please help me. So I'm excited to see what they recommend to me and I will see you guys soon. Hello, okay, we are back. I also stopped at Home Goods with my mask, obviously social distance. Honestly, I kind of love when stores keep it at a very minimal capacity and everyone just has to like stay at least 6 feet apart and the line is spaced and it's just like not people breathing down your neck. Personally, I think the shopping experience is so much better like this, and I would not be mad if we took some of these procedures moving forward when COVID hopefully, you know, becomes a thing of the past. At the rate that the numbers are going in the United States, that could be a while. Anyways, stopped at Home Goods and I want to show you guys some of the things I got, and then also, weed haul. I can't believe that's literally the thing I'm saying. No, this is like just a CBD anti-anxiety haul, essentially. So I got a few things. So I got two Dosist Calm pens because I actually had one from forever ago, but I feel like it's highly, definitely very expired. So I got another one. And then I chatted with the guy at Sweet Flower and got these gummies that are called Wild with a Y. And it's a 20-to-1 ratio of CBD to THC that are supposed to be really great for anxiety. Super cute little packaging, and they are strawberry flavored. Another friend recommended these. They are the Kanha cannabis infused 20-to-1, again, ratio CBD to THC watermelon gummies. So I'm excited. Don't have a ton of experience with the edible format of CBD, and I'm a little scared, I'm not gonna lie. I have more experience with the smoke version, I guess. We are gonna cover all of this in the podcast, but long story short, I got really too high. One of the very first times that I ever did smoke weed, and it really just scarred me forever, and so I've never really been a fan. I also hate the taste of it. I think it tastes like but, and I don't really like the smell of it either. That's where we're at with that. Now on to the wholesome home goods haul. Honestly, I love where this vlog channel has gone and like how it just allows me to speak very freely to you guys. Make sure you're over 21 if you are partaking legally. I'm being really awkward. Okay, we're gonna move on. I don't know how to talk about weed things. It's very new. Okay, so on to the wholesome home goods haul. So the first two things I got are these orthopedic foam crate pads. What a 180. So I feel like Moose loves his bed so much. He loves it so much that we ended up getting a second, like a duplicate of the bed that he originally loved downstairs for his crate upstairs, because he still sleeps in a crate at night and honestly prefers it. Like sometimes we leave the crate door open and he'll sometimes sleep in the bed for a little bit, but usually ditches us to go sleep in the crate because he loves his bed. Anyways, I feel like he's had them for so long that the orthopedic squishy foamies at the bottom of his normal bed are getting a little flat. So I thought that he might like one of these just like underneath his bed, so it's super squishy. So I got one, and honestly I didn't really worry about the color because he won't be able to see it since it'll be under his bed. But I got one for upstairs and one for downstairs. I'm sure Moose will be very excited and appreciate his new comfy bed. I'm sure he won't even notice, but in my heart I want to think that he will love it. And then for the podcast room, which is coming along swimmingly, I got two new pillows because the chairs we're gonna be sitting in are pretty deep. So I feel like because we are old and decrepit, we have both just like struggling back. So a little back support never hurt anyone. So I got a cream and kind of like a steel blue little puff version of this pillow for my side. And then for Jeremy's side, because you know, we like them neutrals, is this really boring grayish brown tan oatmeal matching pillow for his side. Mine's way cuter. Oh my gosh, okay, and then in the line, I feel like they put the good stuff, like the good dumb things you don't need on the shelves that line the checkout line. I got this luxury spa pillow that just suction cups onto the back of your tub so you have something to rest your head on, which honestly, like, it was $4 and I will indeed use this. So did I need it? No, but am I mad at it? Also no. And then I got this cute little organizer for my desk. As you guys know, I've been trying to work at my desk more for productivity, and I feel like I just have an explosion of things over there outside of like the currently 7 beverages on the desk that I need to take care of. And then I actually went to Home Goods hoping to get some more like shelf decor, because we ended up changing the name of the podcast to something new. The artwork ended up being a little bit of a different vibe, so I was hoping to find some new like trinket shelf pieces. Didn't find anything I loved, so I'm gonna look online and see if I can find something that fits the vibe more. But I also got a new dog bed. If you're not buying your dog beds at Home Goods, TJ Maxx, Marshalls, you need to do that because they're so cheap and they're such good quality. So anyway, this is a neutral dog bed to go between the two podcast chairs because Moose wants to be in the podcast room, but he can't quite figure out how to get comfortable on the faux leather chairs on top of us. So I figured if I gave him his own little spot between us, he might be able to settle in there. No, you're overparenting, okay? So anyways, that is the Home Goods haul. Not bad, not mad at it. That pretty much sums up my afternoon. I've got a little more work to do, some emails to answer, and then we gonna start cooking dinner. Oh my god, also like I was about to transition to the next part of the vlog, but Moose sometimes goes nuts when he gets a new bed. He kind of gives it like a roll of approval. So I feel like that's something that we should probably document. He's currently sitting next to me in that little like egg chair that I have in here. So let's see if he's interested in giving this bed a test.
Literally, this dog lives the best life in the entire world.
Oh, Snooks, look at that little cow tummy. Oh my God, I love when he lays on his back more than anything. He just looks like a little piglet. Hello, sweet Snooks. Hello, good morning. I got you a new bed. A new, oh, big stretchies. Who wants to do a bed test? I got you something. What this? What this? Is this for you? Is this a new bed? So that's a bathtub pillow and we don't need that. But what's this? Oh, big stretchies. Do you like it? Is it nice? Is it soft? Is it the comfies? What do you think? Are you just showing everyone your butthole? Not bad, Snooks. Not bad at all. He's so unimpressed. Honestly, I'm a little disappointed. I thought this was gonna go over a little more enthusiastically, I guess. Bubba, this is a new bed. Whose new bed is this? There's nothing in there. Nothing in there. Oh wait, oh my God, weed gummies. They're like in a child safe bag, but oh bless you, wow. Whose new bed is this? Is it your new bed? Got it, all right, noted. Cool, that went well.
Okay, so we're more excited about the orthopedic foam than the new bed. Sir, sir. Sir, 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 sir. You're really jamming your snoot in there.
On to the next part of the vlog.
A bone apple tea dinner is served. I showed you guys in a past vlog, but this is just like my one sheet dinner of just broccoli, sweet potatoes, and chicken sausage, turkey sausage? I think it's chicken sausage. And then I made some quinoa on the side.
Hi guys, it is a little later now, and oh my God, Moose and I just went for a walk, and I feel like I keep walking at literal dusk, and mosquitoes love me. I don't know what blood type I am, but I am the blood type that is delicious to mosquitoes, and it is the worst thing in the entire world. Like, my legs are so beaten up, and I don't even leave the house. But it's only because mosquitoes come and literally have a buffet feast on my legs every night, so love that for me. Anyways, I wanted to ask you guys if anyone has done like a social distancing type of birthday celebration. This is going to be the first year in my entire life that I will not be spending my birthday with my family. I am sad girl hours about it for sure. And so because I am going to be stuck in California, I feel like I should find the silver lining and A, not use the word stuck, and have the opportunity to spend my birthday this year with my LA-based friends, which typically doesn't happen. And like, we always have like an LA celebration at some other time in August usually, but this will be my first birthday where I'm actually in LA for it. So obviously I wish that I could be with family and friends all together in one unrealistic setting and world, but that's not gonna happen. So if anyone has done like a fun social distancing birthday, let me know what you've done. And if it worked and if it was fun and you enjoyed it. I have a few ideas floating around right now, but I don't know. So let me know what you guys have done because I would love to hear some ideas. I made a joke in a TikTok vlog that I was like 56. I said something about like being excited about like, I can't remember what it was. Maybe my air fryer or like, I was like, oh, and like, because I'm 56, I love this. It was just like 100% a joke. And someone in the comments dead ass was like,
wow, I thought she was 26. Wow, she looks really good for her age.
And I was like, girl, what? What do you mean? Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. I'm gonna be on a beach shoot tomorrow, so I might do a little bit of vlogging while I'm there because it's like a social distancing outdoor shoot, which is like the most ideal of all production worlds. So excited for that to be back on set again. But anyways, hope you guys enjoyed the vlog. If you haven't seen Sunday's Sun DIY, it is the dollar store DIY $5 room decor video. So make sure to go check that out, and I will see you guys soon for another vlog. Okay, bye guys, love you.